As they led him away, they seized Simon from Cyrene, who was on his way in from the country, and put the cross on him and made him carry it behind Jesus. A large number of people followed him, including women, who mourned and wept for him. Jesus turned and said to them, "Daughters of Jerusalem, do not weep for me, but weep for yourself and for your children. For the time will come when you will say, 'Blessed are the barren women, the wombs that never bore, and the breasts that never nursed.' Then they will say to the mountains, 'Fall on us,' and to the hill, 'Cover us.' For if man is being on the priest, what will happen when he is right? To other men, what criminals were also led out with him to be executed. When they came to the place called Skull, there they crucified him, along with the criminals, one on his right, the other on his left. Jesus said, 'Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing.' And they divided up his clothes by casting lots. The people stood watching, and the rulers even sneered at him. They said, 'Ha, he saved others. Let him save himself, if he is the Christ of God, the chosen one.' The soldiers also came up and mocked him. They offered him wine vinegar and said, 'If you are the Christ, save yourself.' There was a written on this above him, which read, 'This is the King of the Jews.' One of the criminals who harbored, hurled insults at him, 'I win you the Christ, save yourself and us.' But the other criminals who hungered rebuked him, 'Don't you fear God, since you are under the same sentence, this man? We are punished justly, for we are getting what our deeds deserve. But this man has done nothing wrong.' Then he said, 'Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom.' Jesus answered him, I tell you the truth, today you will be with me in paradise.'